Okay, I figured a little video on this shotgun here. I had a shooting video of it like 5 years ago or something. It's a Hungarian Hammerless single shot shotgun. I think I said in the video they're not super common, I guess, or Hammerless single shots. Most of them have hammers, but there's this one. There was Stevens or Savage made one. There's the Bakels, the Turkish one I got is hammerless, and it's based on like a Beretta one from back in the day. So there's other ones, but see, it has a sliding safety, kind of like a double. Your opening lever, like an internal hammer in here. It's got pretty nice wood on it. I think it's made by FEG, but I'm not sure because all it says is Hammerless and said made in Hungary, and that's all it says on it. It doesn't even says the gauge anywhere on it. Like on the barrel, it mentions the gauge, but it's a serial number, and that's about it. Like it's got the white line spacers and stuff, so it's what's that, 1970s or whatever, whenever that was popular. 60s, I don't know. Nice checkering stuff there, but it's got fairly interesting action the way it cocks itself. Like it's got a little, when you fire it, there's a little part that comes out on the side here, and there's a little lever on the side of the barrel that appears that it shoves that and re-cocks the internal hammer. Like I had the thing apart a few times like years ago because it, if I remember right anyway, the firing pin, I think it's just free floating, and it was all, somebody had been dry firing it, and it was all peened up on the back, and the firing pin would get stuck forward and it wouldn't move back. So it was either it, I forget if it impeded closing the barrel or there was something. Wasn't working right anyway, and I didn't pay a whole lot for the thing. I think it was like 125 bucks or something like that, but it's kind of neat. Like you look up like single shot hammerless Hungarian shotgun or something, you'll see some pictures, but nobody has any, they don't know what the, like there's no model, no anything about it. So they're kind of a, I've never seen this. The first one I ever saw. It's got a steel trigger guard screwed on. Kind of nice. Steel spacer on the hand guard. So maybe I'll take it apart to give you an idea. Try to show you how it, works anyway. So you got, it's got like a, it's like auto eject, like the push. This is attached to it too, this little arm here. You can push this back, and then it'll, this will get locked, like it catches it. If you pull that, then it flies out, and that catches on the edge of the receiver down in here. But there's a little, just like there's the latch, the lock, if you can see it. The light is terrible. There's the latch there, and then on this side of it, there's a little leg that comes out that I believe this is what. Let's see if I can, something I can decock it into. Brass here. Quite a firing pin in it. You can see the firing pin sticking out. Let's see again. Right there. But down on the side of the opening lever, there's a little leg that sticks out. it's right there. And then this, I guess, is what it grabs hold of the bottom of it. You open the barrel. That's why it's quite, it's kind of annoying to open, sort of like when you get a, after you fire it, because you're cocking it, and it's, I don't know, it just seems kind of, it's a bit rough, but it's, it's down there. This catches on it and shoves it back up, and that's recocks it. But the firing pin on this is kind of weird too. Like, it seems like it's going up on a weird angle too, because it's, if I remember right, the hammer is kind of, it comes in on a strange angle because there's something that's inside the receiver there. But it's auto safety, so you push it forward and you open the opening lever, and it's but the opening lever doesn't cock it or anything. Like, it's the process of opening the barrel that does. So kind of like that Turkish one, the little opening lever in front of the trigger guard, you pull that back and that actually cocks the internal hammer. And the Baykel, it's the, you squeeze it back here and that cocks it. And but most doubles, I guess, they sort of, they cock each other when you, the hammers, when you open them, because these, they have these things sticking out the front of the receiver, and the hammers, or the springs, and the hammers run inside, and they have little things sticking out, and you use those little things in the back of the handguard that they go into, and you open it, that, they'll shove that back, so you can... Like, a lot of people, like, it's not annoying with hammerless doubles. A lot of times you got to open them and it cocks them. But if you take the handguard off, a lot of times you can open them and look at them without actually cocking the thing. So, but anyway, it's pretty well put together. It looks like it's a casting the receiver, but it's not a big deal with a shotgun. It says on the barrel, let's see if it's still good. Yeah, battery's still doing okay. The serial number, it's got, it says smokeless powder, it says 17.8, which is millimeters for, it's like 701 or 700.8 or something. It's sort of, I guess that would be considered, it's not quite full, but it's not quite modified. I think sort of like proof modified or something or other, I guess, what it is. But don't see a whole lot else on it. Like, it's, I don't know if it's all one piece or not. I think this, the lug might be, but it's hard to tell. I'll see a, kind of see where they soldered that on, I think. Bronzed on. But it's got a, like, a hefty barrel on it. Pretty thick. But I don't know, like, what the model these are, when they came into the country. They're pretty well put together. Like, they're well polished and everything. Like, they're not, like, just some thrown together, you know. And they got a fairly complex action, the way it works is kind of neat. It's probably more complicated than it has to be, but it's sort of, they're all pretty well. This kind of reminds me of like a TUI, the way that is. So the little, this thing looks just like an 84 TUI almost. Kind of surprising. But it's, I don't know. Kind of, they're kind of nice, like, so I always kind of like hammer guns mostly, but they're, this kind of stuff for just for hunting, it is a lot nicer because you can get onto the game a lot quicker. And a lot of hammer single barrel shotguns, the hammers, they got this, like, they roll back, and they're, you know, especially if you're bird hunting in colder climes, a little bit chilly, and you got like numb fingers or something, it's gonna be a little bit problematic to get the hammer pulled back and But anyway, it's just, it keeps a bunch of junk from getting down in there too, but it's just kind of nice, I guess. So I seen the thing. I never seen one like it before, and it wasn't very expensive, so I figured, I was like, hey, I gotta have that. It's kind of neat. So, anyway, thanks for watching, guys. If anybody has any information on the thing or what bottle it is or actually who's actually made by, it's probably like FEG. I think it's the only people I've heard of that are actually in like Hungary that made guns, but I'm sure there's other people, maybe. I don't know. Because they made doubles and stuff I've seen for sale. But anyway, it's a pretty nice gun. It probably wasn't that terrible expensive back in the day when it was communist Hungary or whatever. So, see, communism works, guys. You can get really good quality products and it doesn't cost anything. Anyway, thanks for watching. We will talk to you later.